and welcome to CCTV. I'm your host, Conrad Angel Correll. It's summertime, and it's hot, right? It's really, really hot. And this is a good opportunity for you to get out of your kitchen and come to Cathedral City's newest restaurant, Beyond Belisage, located here at the Cathedral City Plaza, just doors down from Revivals. This is a family-run business serving earth-to-table cuisine. Let's go inside and see what's cooking. All right, everybody, I am joined now by the owner and, of course, the chef here at Beyond Belisage, Daniel Villanueva. Thank you for joining us here today.
Thank you for having me.
Of course, of course. We're very glad to be here. And, of course, I want to say welcome to Cathedral City. I understand that you are a resident of Cathedral City, and you have some kind of association with The Cove, which is where your restaurant is located at. Tell me a little bit about that association with The Cove.
Well, our association with The Cove is actually the other half of me, which is my wife, and she grew up actually up here in The Cove.
And we all have another half, right?
Yes, we all have another half. So she actually grew up here in The Cove many moons ago, before it was developed, obviously, to what it is now. You know, little did we know, you know, many years later that we would be have a restaurant here in Cat City, but there's a lot of history. We're happy to be here.
Well, great. And so let's talk a little bit about how you pick a location.
Well, I would say, honestly, a location tends to pick you. Mm-hmm. Being centered, I believe, for us here in Cathedral City, just happened naturally between Palm Springs and Palm Desert.
I'm a firm believer of that. When we bought our house up in the Cove, I used to come here and hang out in Palm Springs and stay at hotels in Palm Springs and now and then come to Cathedral City or a little bit further. And when I bought my house here, I realized that I can go equally to the left and I can go equally to the right and there are things to be done. And so it was really a good spot to actually be right here in the middle of Cathedral City where you can go everywhere, which is kind of what you're saying.
Absolutely.
Right. This restaurant, or your restaurant, says that you are earth-to-table cuisine. Now, I don't know about viewers, but I've heard quite often farm-to-table cuisine. Is earth-to-table the same thing as farm-to-table? And if it's not, how does it differ?
Well, it differs in the aspect that I think when you have a better connection to the earth and understanding how desperately we need it, then the connection goes beyond the farm. And when you have had the opportunity, like myself, to get out to these farms and visit these families that are growing the vegetables and raising the grass-fed meats, you get a deeper sense. It becomes a deeper sense when you're there than just being on a farm.
You obviously have a restaurant, but you are offering catering. You are offering private events, including a 5-course organic meal or organic wine dinners, cooking classes, menu plannings for home.
So since some people are even that busy, well, instead of running through the drive-thru, they'll stop here. They come inside. I have their name and I have their Monday, their Tuesday, their Wednesday lunches.
Oh, is that right?
I have their Monday, their Tuesday, their Wednesday dinners. And they come, they pick up. They're in glass containers that are oven-proof. I promote ovens, not microwaves. We don't have a microwave here. And so they just preheat their oven. I'm big on timers too, so nothing gets burnt. Set the timer, put it in the oven. You go open your bottle of wine or take a bath or what have you and come back and your timer goes off. You come back and you take your food out and it's ready.
So I was looking at a menu here that's called a mezze menu.
I wanted to offer Cathedral City and surrounding areas our version of happy hour. And so is what I composed was this wine and mezze, which if you research the history of mezze and the wine, it's really about just coming together after a long work day and just enjoying other people next to you sharing stories in their day and having wine and partaking in multitudes or different small dishes.
So almost kind of like a tapa experience?
If you visit the west of the Mediterranean, which would be more Spain and France, for example, as opposed to Lebanon and Syria, it's similar concept, just a different way of approaching it. Okay. So to answer your question, yes, but different.
A friend of mine says same, same, but different. The mezze would take place in almost kind of what I would say would be the bar area, but it's more than the bar area. That's the chef's cook area. What would you call that space?
Well, we call it the chef's table.
Chef's table, okay.
It's exactly where you're literally 5 feet from the kitchen. And
you're experiencing that.
You're experiencing your food being prepared and brought out to you all in that one time frame that you're here.
So why don't you tell us about a few of the items that are on the mezze menu?
Well, what I've decided to do is take larger ideas and make them smaller. One, for example, is a pastilla dish that I do that is on my signature dish menu. And what I do is I make it this big.
And what is it a paella? Is that a rice?
It's like a 9-spice chicken dish that I do, where we put a sunny up egg on top with a little phyllo square on the bottom.
That sounds delicious.
So you get creamy, you get cinnamon, you get paprika, you get various spices, toasted coriander and cumin seeds. But you get the creaminess and the richness of the egg because they're organic, but you get the texture and the crunchiness of the phyllo underneath.
So let's talk about maybe some of the signature dishes that you would present at the table. What would some of those?
There's a braised lamb dish that I also do that I did before. I used to wrap it in phyllo, and now I took a spin off a further eastern town, and now I just serve it in a bowl on top of vegetables that we steam, and it's just braised lamb cooked with multitudes and layers of flavors.
That sounds terrific. And what about, do you serve a vegetarian dish?
Well, the cool thing about being vegetarian is that I'll make you something per your request.
Well, I think the menu sounds exciting. I think the food is probably going to be done from the heart and with love.
And those are
all great reasons for you to come out here to Beyond Balisage. I want to talk about this one last thing before we start tasting some of this delicious food. Many restaurants close during summertime, and you have chosen to open during summertime. And those restaurants that are open usually offer some kind of incentive, a 2-3-4 course meal to come in. I believe you have this type of incentive going on. And I love the title, Summer Love Dinner. What is the title of your
Summertime Love.
Summertime Love. And that is how many course meal?
It's a 3-course meal that you get to choose which 3 courses you'd like off of the signature menu or off of the chalkboard specials, and you make it your way. You choose whatever salad or hors d'oeuvre you'd like, you choose whatever entree you'd like, and you choose whatever pastry that you'd like. So
that works for me.
and it can be paired with wine on top of that
Okay, I will. Quit forcing me. That sounds terrific. All right, let's try some food. So, of course, now I'm here to do some of the tasting. And joining me for the first time on camera, I think, is my husband, Robert Durbin, going to be here enjoying some food with us today. So you ready for this?
Yes.
Okay.
Come on, bring it on.
All right, sounds good. So let's see.
So we have a mousse. That's Tomcord grapes. That's a hybrid of Thomason and Concord grapes with sea bean that comes from Murray Farms. The sea bean is edible and has a slight salty flavor. You'll take the leaf and eat that with the grape, and it'll pop in your mouth and it'll cleanse your palate. Prepare it for the culinary delights that will be coming.
So the idea is take a little bit of the greenery and
Correct.
A little bit of the berry.
Correct. And there's a stem down the middle, so you'll eat around that.
Okay. I think we could do that.
Thank you. Enjoy.
Something new. We'll see what happens. It's almost definitely salty. And somehow it goes together. I don't know why, but it definitely works.
Okay, so this is the wine that we have that is sulfite free.
And now all of your wines are organic, is that correct?
All of our wines are organic. They're all Mediterranean.
And so why is sulfur so? I can't say it. Sulfite free. Why is that important? Why is that an interesting?
The chef is very conscious of nutrition and health and healing. Everything being healthy for your body.
I would have no idea. I would have no idea that I didn't need to have that. And let's look at the bottle, because I'm a firm believer that if the bottle's pretty, it probably tastes delicious. All right, let's go ahead. And I'm always a big fan of a healthy pour rather than a small pour. So this works for me. Great, thank you much.
Especially $5 a glass.
You can't beat that at all.
All right.
Thank you. Well, salute. So,
chicken.
Wow.
That's a resemblance of the pastilla, chicken pastilla. And this is a sample of our pan-seared sea scallops with a date sauce, which has...
Is this a date here?
Wow. No. Yes, yes. Organic medjool dates, as well as organic honey, cinnamon stick, fresh herbs, and spices, all reduced down. That's very delicious. Both of those are very nice.
Great. Sounds good. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I know it definitely does not have a barbecue sauce on it, but there's definitely some kind of a glaze that really makes chicken really taste good. And I personally like to have the yolk on it. I don't know, I've never thought about doing something like that, but it's pretty good.
This is really good. It's sweet and there's some spice, and it has a good crunch to the crust.
I don't know about you, but we tried making scallops once, and it wasn't a disaster, it wasn't a success, but we're definitely going to try it again. So we're always for scallops. It was successful, that's what I meant to say, right?
All right, so we have baklava.
Well, that's a nice hearty, hearty baklava.
And we have the blueberry trifle.
Oh my gosh, that looks delicious. So we definitely saw this being made earlier. We're watching the chef as he was putting it all together. It's almost like a really soft cookie with, I don't know what this glaze is on top of it, but that's delicious. It's so good. And I have to say, I'm not necessarily a fan of baklava, not because it's not delicious, but mainly because I think it's so sweet. However, I'm going to try it anyways, because right, you have to go for it anyways.
It is a dessert.
It is a dessert. Again, if you lick your fingers after you've tasted it, it's got to be delicious. I think as we finish our dessert now, I want to thank Beyond Belisage for having us here tonight, for inviting us both together. And please come out here and enjoy a meal. It's a dining experience here at Beyond Belisage. I'm Conrad Carell for CCTV. We'll see you here.